सिरिल ढाबरिलो सायरे साहूकार
अरे
सुरेश मेरे
एंड द
खवा को
ओनर
स्पीकिंग
ओनर ऑफ द
स्पीकिंग
चैनल
ऐसा मत बोलो
राकेश
वी आर ऑल इन दिस टुगेदर इफ समथिंग बैड हैपेंस दैट्स व्हाई आई जस्ट वांट टू शेयर दिस ब्लेम
कैसा लगा मेरा मजाक
आई एम जस्ट गोना गेट राइट टू द पॉइंट
ओके
ये स्टोरी जो है ये मेरी मेरे एक दोस्त है तो उसका स्टोरी है तो व्हेन ही वाज इन कॉलेज इट्स एन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज इन रायपुर मैं कॉलेज वाले इसका नाम वाम अभी वो सब डजंट मैटर एंड वो लोग ऐसा होता था ना कि वो रूम में एक डॉर्मेटरी होता है ना फर्स्ट ईयर्स को जैसे ला के रख देते हैं तो फोर फाइव पीपल स्टे टुगेदर उनमें से एक हमेशा ऐसे होता है ना कॉलेज में सेकेंड ईयर का जो आके कूल बनता है कि यार भाई लोग मेरे पंटर लोग तुम लोगों को दिखाता हूँ ऐसा एक जगह दिखाता हूँ यार तुम लोगों को देखा ही नहीं होगा तो ऐसे करके वो लोग भाई वो एक दिन रात में ऐसा एक जगह लेके गया उसको मतलब तीन चार लोगों को एक सीनियर उनको लेके गया तो दैट प्लेस इज लाइक रियली लाइक सेक्लूडेड वहाँ पे दो तीन ऐसे टूम स्टोन है और एक छोटा सा एक मतलब एक पॉन्ड जैसा है पॉन्ड जैसे एक रिजर्वर होता है ना जैसे मोस्टली डैम्स के किनारे जैसे रिजर्वर
समझ
होते
गया
हैं
समझ गया।
हाँ जी
हाँ
हाँ जी तो वहाँ पे ऐसे स्टोन्स के रहते हैं कि जैसे उस साइड में जैसे स्टोन्स रहते हैं ना जहाँ वेयर यू कैन सिट एंड लाइक चेक चिल अराउंड इट्स लाइक एनी पिक्यूलियर डैम तो सब लोग बैठे थे एक साथ मतलब रात में एक एक जन उनमें से है कि यार मैं ये करना नहीं चाहता मुझे ऐसे कुछ ना कुछ ऐसे फीलिंग आ रहा है कि यार कुछ तो गलत है ये है तो उसको बोले नहीं यार फट्टू है ये है वो है फिर से नहीं होगा तो उसको ऐसे कुछ ना कुछ लग रहा था तो उस दिन कुछ हुआ नहीं वो लौट आए सब लोग ऐसे रूम पे आके बैठे तो आफ्टर 1 वीक उसी बंदे का एक्चुअली बर्थडे था तो वही सीनियर और एक जन सीनियर और एक दो सीनियर मिलके उनको बोले कि नहीं यार तेरे को आज तेरा लाइक तेरा सारे सारा डर भगाएंगे तेरा डर का वर्जिनिटी तोड़ेंगे ऐसा करके उसको लेके गए वही जगह पे तो प्रॉब्लम ये हुआ कि वहां पे चले गए सब लोग ऐसे कुछ मतलब कोई कुछ बोल नहीं रहा कुछ नहीं और बैठे हैं रात को वैसे रात को जैसे 12-1 बजे गए हैं पूरा वहां पे जाके थोड़ा ड्रिंक विंक करते हैं वो सब करते हैं फिर क्या होता है एक पॉइंट पे एक जन ऐसे निकलता है ऐसे डराने के लिए उसको बोलता है भाई जो भी कर डोंट थ्रो अ स्टोन टू दैट पॉन्ड मतलब उसकी मतलब जैसे दिख रहा है ना जैसे पूरा शांत जगह है डोंट मतलब मेक अ मूव उसमें डिप नहीं करना अपना पैर जैसा है वो है जैसा है वैसा रहने थे पर क्या हुआ ना उसने मतलब एक और बंदे ने ऐसे आके जोश में आके फेंक दिया ऐसे एक स्टोन फेंका तो वैसे जस्ट मतलब मजे में जैसे करते हैं कुछ टाइम बाद ये लोग ऐसे मजे में बैठे हुए हैं वो जो बंदा जिसका बर्थडे था वो अलग होके बैठा था मतलब ही डिडंट ड्रिंक एंड ऑल मतलब उसको मन ही नहीं था क्योंकि उसका वैसे ही फट रहा था वो बैठा था बस ये लोग ऐसे पार्टी वार्टी कर रहे हैं मजे कर रहे हैं मजाक वगैरह करके जब जाते थे जब उनको जाना होता है तब वो लोग आके देखते हैं कि यार ये मतलब क्यों ये मतलब बैठा हुआ है इसका कुछ मतलब इसका बर्थडे है मतलब ही शुड मतलब थोड़ा तो मूड अच्छा होना चाहिए पर वो लोग जाके उसको देखते हैं कि यार चल भाई वो तो नहीं सुन रहा है मतलब ही डजंट रेस्पॉन्ड टू एट ऑल फिर क्या होता है ना एक दो जन फिर ऐसे करते हैं कि नहीं यार आ ही जाएगा वो लोग आके बाइक पे बैठे हैं यार आ जा भाई क्या हुआ वो नहीं आ रहा है वो सब ऐसे मतलब सबको ऐसा लग रहा है कि यार मैं भी वो प्रैंक कर रहा है या जो भी हो उसकी फट गई या जो भी हो ऐसा करके तीन चार जन पूरा उसको आके पूरा मतलब खींच के लेके जाने के लिए पूरा जोर जोर लगा रहे हैं कि यार आ भाई क्या हो गया क्या हो गया बस एक मोमेंट में बस वो पीछे देख ही नहीं रहा था बस इन लोगों की तरफ बस ऐसे मतलब विदाउट सेइंग अ वर्ड वो बस वो पॉन्ड की तरफ ही देखता रहा मतलब देख पूरा जैसे स्टिल होके देख रहा था एक तरफ एक जन उसका पूरा जाके जैसे मतलब ही गॉट फ्राइटेन कि रात के 3 बजे ये यार ऐसे बैठा रहेगा क्या करे वो बस उसको मतलब जबरदस्ती जब खींचने लगा तो वो पीछे बस मुड़ के उसको देखा कि ब्रो कैसे जाऊं यार बोल क्या हुआ प्रॉब्लम क्या मतलब तेरे को जाना नहीं है तो करना क्या चाहता है तेरे को ब्रो मैं कैसे जाऊं वो मुझे जाने ही नहीं तेरी
ओह बॉय ओह शिट
नो नो
फिर ये लोग पूरा डर के, मतलब कौन, मैं वो कुछ नहीं बोला फिर कि वो मुझे जाने ही नहीं दे रही यार। मैं ये लोग डर रहे हैं कि यार ये सच में कर रहा है या प्रैंक कर रहा है ये जो भी हो। फिर एक टाइम पे सब इरिटेटेड हो गए, वो सीनियर वीनियर उसका भाई पूरा माथा चढ़ गया, पूरा क्या कर रहा है ये। उसका भी धीरे धीरे फटने लगा है कि एवरीबॉडी वाज लाइक दिस वाज लाइक अनएक्सपेक्टेड, ये तो कभी नहीं होता था। फिर धीरे धीरे उसको जबरदस्ती लेके जब खींच के जा रहे थे, ही वाज लाइक सम पीपल लाइक ही वाज लाइक प्रिटेंडिंग कि ही समवन इज उसका हाथ कोई खींच रहा है दूसरी तरफ, ये लोग जैसे खींच के जा रहे। तो ये लोगों के अभी भी लग रहा था कि जैसे ड्रंक गाइस कैसे लगता है कि यार कोई मजाक कर रहा है कि रात को 3 बजे क्यों ऐसे करेगा।
गॉड
सब लोग जाके उसको ऐसे करके बाइक के पीछे बैठे हैं, जैसे ट्रिपलिंग करके जाते हैं ना उसको, वैसे एक जन को बीच में बिठा के वो बंदे को उसको लेके जा रहे हैं। तो फिर एक बीच में एक पॉइंट आया कि वो तभी भी ऐसे हाथ पीछे ऐसे करके बाइक से, जैसे समवन इज ड्रैगिंग बिहाइंड ऐसे करके उसको हाथ पीछे करके वो बैठा हुआ है। तो उस टाइम पे तो वैसे कुछ नोबडी सेड अ वर्ड और एनीथिंग बिकॉज सबका फट रहा था। हॉस्टल तक पहुंच गए, हॉस्टल के लिए जब उतरे वो, समवन नोटिस की उनमें से जो 4-5 जन थे कि समवन नोटिस की यार इसका हाथ इतना, इट्स लाइक समवन हैज ग्रैब्ड योर हैंड फॉर लाइक मोर देन 5 or 10 minutes। इट्स
Oh
लाइक
my
सम
God, he had bruises on his hand.
Oh yeah. Oh
Not
my
exactly
God.
bruises, someone like the
That
blood clots.
marks. समझ गया,
marks, marks,
God, oh
marks.
God, on his wrist. उसके
Yeah,
wrist पे
yeah.
होगा.
Exactly, exactly. So
So
they just
तोते उड़ गए, तोते उड़ गए मेरे.
हाँ, कान फट गई पूरा सब
That
पूरा।
too.
फिर क्या हुआ ना, कोई कुछ बोला नहीं, ये सब सबके लिए ये चीज दिस वाज फ्राइटनिंग। सो एवरीबॉडी वेंट टू द देयर रूम्स, पर वो चार तीन चार जन जैसे उनके डॉर्मेटरी में वो जाके बैठ गए सो गए। मिडल ऑफ द नाइट समवन वेक्स अप, वन ऑफ द फोर पीपल वेक्स अप एंड सीज दैट ही इज जस्ट सिटिंग ऑन
टंग
हिज बेड। ओके, या ही इज जस्ट सिटिंग ऑन द बेड एंड ही द अदर गाय, द गाय दैट वेक्स अप ही जस्ट लाइक नहीं मैं भाई कुछ नहीं करने वाला, ये भाई मेरे को डर लग रहा है भाई, मैं नहीं कर रहा है कुछ। कुछ टाइम बाद सुबह जब पूरा ऐसा वो सो जाता है, वो सुबह सुबह जब तीन लोग सब लोग उठ रहे हैं, उठ के देख रहा हूँ वैसे ही बैठा है बेड के साइड पे। ठीक है, और ऐसा पूरा दिन मतलब वैसे उसके बाद क्या हुआ ना, उसको फिर जबरदस्ती पर किया तू क्या कर रहा है ये, ऐसा नहीं वैसा नहीं, उस दिन वो क्लास भी नहीं गया, ऐसा कुछ नहीं हुआ। अगले रात को, उस रात को ये फिर ये लोग बोले कि नहीं हम तो नहीं सोने वाले क्योंकि हमें वी आर हैविंग द सेम थिंग, ये लोग अगर ये रात को फिर से अगर ये सब हुआ तो नहीं करेंगे। तो क्या हुआ ना, इस बार रात को दे मतलब दे सॉ दैट ही इज लाइक टॉकिंग टू समवन, लाइक समवन इज सिटिंग
Oh my
ऑन ऑन
gosh, Sheila.
या समवन इज सिटिंग
Oh
ऑन हिज बेड
God. ऐसे
एंड ही
नहीं
इज
बोला
लाइक
था क्या?
टॉकिंग टू हर, लाइक नॉट इवन जस्ट लाइक कन्वर्सिंग, इज लाइक टॉकिंग स्वीटली, लाइक ही हैज फॉलन इन लव विद दैट गर्ल और समवन, लाइक ही ही फेल्ट लाइक द गर्ल हैज बीन लाइक फॉलोइंग हिम सिंस दैट पॉन्ड दिस प्लेस एंड लाइक दे हैव फॉलन इन लव। वही होता है कि रात पर वैसा ही टाइम ये लोग फिर चिल्लाते हैं, फिर क्या भाई क्या कर रहा है क्या नहीं है वो, ही रेस्पॉन्स नथिंग। नेक्स्ट डे वही होता है कि उसके घर को फिर कॉल किए, पेरेंट्स ऑन केम एंड दे टुक हिम, लाइक उस वो मतलब 1 साल के अंदर ही जस्ट ही कुडंट इवन फिनिश हिज लाइक
माय गॉड, तो
ग्रेजुएशन।
दिस स्टोरी एंड्स हियर बाबा. तुम लोग को शादी में बुलाया कि नहीं?
Great, great
I
beginning.
got scared. I'll give you a 6 to 7 on 10. Somebody gave me a 2 on 10 saying कि 0 से अच्छा है.
कौन
है तो
बड़ा दिल
आराम
है,
आराम
इट्स अ
ही चाहे.
पॉजिटिव वे टू गो, कर दिल.
आई डोंट नो हाउ पीपल रिमेन फ्रेंड्स विद पीपल लाइक दिस, लाइक इफ समवन जोकिंग अराउंड विद मी एंड वे लाइक इमेजिन यू गो टू अ पार्टी एंड पीपल आर लाइक व्हाटएवर मदाइल व्हाटएवर एंड दे स्टार्ट बिहेविंग लाइक दिस, आई स्टॉप बीइंग फ्रेंड्स विद देम इफ आई फाइंड आउट दैट दे वर जोकिंग। इट हैज टू बी रियल देन,
व्हाट डू यू मीन?
एज यू कांट डू दिस एज अ जोक।
Yeah,
but
would
yeah,
you
yeah.
want to be friends with them if it's real? That's even worse.
No, I'm saying the only excuse is if it is real.
So the story is from Carter Road. I don't know if you guys know Rajan Village.
Yeah, Rajan, oh God, that's over here.
That's please, like, very close to where OJ
Don't tell me stories from next to my house. What the hell? Please.
So this happened in the early 2000s. And back then I was still in school. And my neighbor, who was a few years younger than me, we used to all play together. And her elder sister was my very close friend. So this young girl, let's just call her Nisha. And yeah, one afternoon when we were playing, Nisha just takes the broom. We were all playing house. And she takes the broom and starts sweeping the garden. Wonderful. It was very off for an eight-year-old to do that.
Yeah.
But as days started passing during the 90s, her behavior started getting more aggressive. So one evening she was sleeping beside her cousin in their house, and she just looked at him and started rotating her eyes. So he got freaked out and he told her parents and everything. They got freaked out. So they started asking her to sleep beside them. They had about four or five rooms. It was a joint family. So then after that, since her behavior started getting way abnormal, they kept her beside them. And one night when she woke up beside her dad, she had a knife in her hand.
Oh my God. This is an 8-year-old child.
And yeah. And he got really freaked out because he noticed that she was eating thrice the amount of food that she would normally eat. And her dialect had started changing. She started speaking in Haryanvi. And she continued sweeping the garden and everything else during the day. And she started wearing slippers that were like four or five times bigger than her size. She was a normal 8-year-old girl, and it was irrational. And then after they saw the knife in her hand, they took her to their village in Gujarat. And when they went there, they found out that she was possessed. And are you guys there?
Sorry. Yeah.
You're not alone.
Her uncle had taken her to Danda on the first day. He bought her a samosa pav, and she was walking by with her uncle passing the cremation ground that they have at Danda,
right,
between Danda and Cart Road.
That's right.
And this lady was being buried there that day. And she possessed this 8-year-old girl and refused to leave her body till they offered her some chicken and some red sari, and they had to do the entire puja in their village in Gujarat. But for those 8-9 days, this girl had gone completely insane.
Oh my God.
So she's okay now?
She's fine. So they managed to get the ghost out of her, and she was fine after that.
I know if Jose possesses somebody, I mean, that person will ask for a 3090 graphics card or, you know, some PC.
If I possess someone, suddenly their parents are like, this person, our child is sleeping all day. They're not doing anything. They're just eating and sleeping and eating and sleeping. The guy is definitely possessed by Jose.
I think my friend's wife told me, she was a photographer, and she told me about this woman. It was not a horror story, but about a woman who stuffed her grandmother up in Bandra.
Hi.
Oh God!
It's almost like you were replying to what Cyrus was saying. Like, hi, I'm here. It was me. It was me.
Hi. Good? Yeah, I'm a little.
Are you from Marol?
No.
My uncle has been, he has been practicing priesthood in the U.S. This happened in 1990s. He was in Oakland County. Oakland County is in Michigan, and it's a very small community. Everybody knows everyone there. So a family of five people moved into a house. Okay. And that was an old house, 200 years old, built by some Dutch architect. It had that European, elegance touch to it, and looked very beautiful. So a family of five people moved in. Wife, okay, she was a, stay-at-home mom. Her husband was a male nurse, so most of the time he would do night shift, because back then, there was a huge demand for guys night shift to take care of patients. And they had three kids. One was 12 years old, the other one was 8, and the little one was 4 years old. So he used to play on a tricycle. He loved to play on that tricycle day in and day out. So they moved into the new house. They had that housewarming party, and they realized that the house needed a paint job to be done. And this was early 90s. Okay, so they didn't have internet. They didn't have any, WhatsApp or anything. So they reached out to the neighbors and they gave some contact numbers. They said, okay, can you reach out to these contractors? They'll get your job done. So this is a very strange thing. Okay, this lady called out to four different people. At the start, they would say, yeah, definitely we'll come to your house and get the paint job done. As soon as the lady narrated the address, they would come up with some excuse. Sorry, you know, this year we are booked. We can't come to your house, or we are running out of manpower, so on and so forth. So this started, this triggered some suspicion in that lady as to why nobody is willing to come to a house to get the job done. It's not one, four contractors have denied after claiming that they have the availability. And this was, one minute. So this started adding suspicion, and she started inquiring with the neighbors. Do you know anything wrong with this house? So the neighbor told her that, don't you know, there have been 10 families living before you guys came, and every family, there has been a death, at least one death in the family who has come to live in this house. There is something definitely unnatural about this house. If you get a chance, you should move out. But then these guys had already taken mortgage and, they were neck deep in loans, so they couldn't take the risk of moving out of the house. So a few weeks passed by, there was no paranormal activity. One day when the husband was doing night shift, this lady hears somebody walking down the hallway. Okay, and it's a hard walk. And sometimes, these old houses, they make creaky sound, but it was not a creaky sound. It was a man walking across the hallway. It was a very clear sound. She went out to investigate what is it, but she couldn't see anyone. Okay, she couldn't see anyone. Nobody was around. Later, in the morning when the husband came, she started telling the husband, see, I feel that there is something wrong with this house. Last night when I was in my bedroom, I could hear somebody walking. But then when I, went out to investigate, there was nobody. So the husband is a skeptic. Okay, he doesn't believe in God. We can say he's an agnostic. So it's like, see, there is no such thing as ghost. Okay, I believe in science, and I don't think there is ghost or God or any of that sort. You're just over-dramatic. You're being a little over-dramatic. Forget about it. Probably this is an old house, so it might make some creaky sound. So ignore about it. So a few days passed by again. She could hear the footsteps. One night again, when her husband is not there, she could hear somebody smashing the crockeries in the kitchen. Okay, smashing as in literally, there are three kids in the house along with this lady, and they can hear somebody smashing the crockeries. They go inside in the kitchen to investigate. Nothing is broken. Everything is in order. Okay, spick and span. Nothing is, sometimes when she's, doing her household chores, the faucet would go on automatically. Okay. She remembers that she had turned the faucet on, but the faucet would go on its own. So this was the initial stage of paranormal activity. Later on, again, few days passed by, her elder son, 12 years old, one night, and in the US, they have different bedrooms. Okay. The husband and wife would sleep in a different bedroom, and kids would sleep in a different bedroom. So this younger kid, the elder one started yelling. Okay. He had a nightmare in the middle of the night, and he was yelling. And luckily the husband was also at home. The lady's husband was also at home. So they went to investigate what happened. And this is what the guy says. Okay. The boy says that I saw a guy with a black dog. It looked a hybrid between a dog and a wolf, just next to my bed. And when I woke up, the dog attacked me. So the husband is like, no, it's not possible. You might be watching a lot of horror movies. You're just, overthinking about it. And he moves out of the room. When the lady is about to move, she notices that there is a fur ball. Okay, they don't have any pets in the house. They notice a fur ball of a black dog on the carpet. Now, this is, again, she gets a little spooked about it because they don't have any animals. They don't have any pets in the house. Where did this ball of fur come from? So later that morning, in the morning, it's only two of them. Okay. Husband and wife, they are having discussion. Okay. So husband, again, he doesn't believe in ghosts. So the wife tells the husband, there is definitely something wrong in the house. The other day I heard somebody smashing the, crockery in the kitchen. Nobody was there. Everything was in order. I can hear somebody walking down the hallway. I don't see anyone. And now these nightmares, I don't want my kids to sleep alone in the bedroom. I want them here. And the husband is like, see, I don't believe in ghosts and all, but if you are okay, I can get a paranormal investigator to come and investigate. I don't want priest to come here and do his mumbo jumbo. I don't believe in all that stuff. So let a paranormal investigator come here. Let us prove it scientifically what is going on. So at the same night, okay, same night, all three of them are sleeping in the same room. Okay, everybody is sleeping in the same room along with the three kids. At 1 a.m., this younger son, he wakes up, or he gets up facing towards his parents. Okay, his eyeballs are rolled back and he's murmuring something. He's constantly murmuring something. And this breaks the sleep of his parents. They wake up and they try to understand what this boy is saying. Now, the boy is narrating the same argument the mother and the father had in the morning when nobody was around, word to word. Okay, it's verbatim, as if he was there. But then there was nobody around, right? So he's telling everything, what the father says, he's being skeptic, and what the mother is trying to prove, and then get a paranormal investigator. And the end, he says, do your best to get rid of me. I'm not going anywhere. This is what he says.
With his eyes rolled back up.
Yeah, he's not in his senses. And the voice is completely different. It's not of a boy. Okay. There are two or three different voices coming out of his mouth. They reach out to the neighbors. They try to figure out what went wrong with this house. Nobody has any idea, but they say that, every family who has lived in this house has left the house in the middle of the night. They have been so scared. Something is not right with the house. And at least one family member would die.
Oh my God.
Luckily, they try to reach out to a paranormal investigator. And again, he's booked. Okay. He says that I might come to your house a few days later. Now, this paranormal investigator is an ex-Marine. He worked in the, I think he served in Vietnam. So he's a tough guy, mentally very strong. But then there are a few days, for him to come and inspect the house. One night, okay, again, the husband is doing night shift. One night, this lady gets up and she goes to the kitchen to have a glass of water. She hears some noise coming from the porch, okay. She goes out and she tries to investigate what is going on. She can see that it's not windy, but the tricycle, which the son uses to play, is moving back and forth, going in circles, as if somebody is riding that bicycle. Okay. And then suddenly the bicycle just, turns towards that lady, as if the person or something who is sitting on the bicycle knows that the lady is watching. Okay. And she completely, you feel that when you're scared, you will yell, you'll scream on the top of your voice, but the hair at the back of this lady's neck stood up, it stands up and she's not able to move. She's completely scared.
Frozen.
Yeah, frozen. But few minutes later, she feels that something was, gripping her, and later that thing lets her go. So she runs to her husband and she runs back and she calls her up her husband at work. This is definitely not done. This house is definitely, haunted. So a few days later, this paranormal investigator also comes. And sorry, this is a lengthy story, but please bear with
me.
Quite
long.
No. We're all here. It's going good.
Yeah, and this paranormal investigator is 6'3", well-built, again, ex-Marine, places the camera on the table, and he also has a tape recorder. So he puts the tape recorder on and he places the camera in such a way that he can capture whatever is going on in the kitchen, because that is where most of the paranormal activity happens, the shattering of the plates and all. And then this guy, he tries to establish a communication. He reaches out to the, he challenges, whatever you are, you're only good at showing your dominance over a lady. Why don't you show it to me? When he says that, few seconds later, his camera just flies across the kitchen. Oh. Okay, as if something just lifted it and threw it away. And this guy starts yelling, this ex-military guy, he starts yelling on the top of his voice, as if somebody has poured acid on his back. Then he removes the shirt, and they can see that there are three claws, Mark. Okay, there are claws on the back of his back, and it is burning. So he gets extremely scared and he's like, I've never seen anything like this. I cannot stay in your house. And he moves out. He moves out, and that is when the guy, the male, understands that there is definitely spooky about this house.
The husband.
So he reaches out to the priest. So he reaches out. He tries to get some help from the priest. So back in those days, it was not that easy, to perform an exorcism. You need to get an approval from the Pope,
the church,
and from the church. And you Vatican. Also have to understand what you're dealing with, right? You can't just go and start performing exorcism. Yeah. And once the exorcism start, this boy, 12-year-old, he completely changes into something else. His back is arched. and he's talking in different voices, okay? And he's actually telling the past of my uncle, which nobody knows, like where he's from and what he has done. And he's challenging him, go ahead and try to get rid of me. I'm not going anywhere. And while doing exorcism, you know, this thing is also speaking into my uncle's mind that if you don't, if this exorcism is not successful, we are coming after you and we are more than one.
What?
And then my uncle told you should not, you know, dig anything or do any changes to this property. Best thing is you should leave this property and go. Till date, that house is vacant and the government, you know, they're planning to break it. It's not broken. They're planning to tear down the house. So it's a wow. true story. It's not been revealed, but
please, please tell your uncle not to do that. You know, if they tear down that house and build a complex over there, Mulund mein problem hai. We know that now.
Yeah. No, I mean, that place will be left alone. I mean, nothing will happen. Yeah.
Bro, the part that really freaked me out the most is when we said that, you know, you can try to get rid of me as much as you want. I'm not going anywhere. I was like,
yes.
In the starting, he said my uncle is an exorcist. I heard my uncle is exhausted. And I was like, why is he telling us that his uncle is exhausted? Anyway,
at 6'3".
Obviously, you know, in the chat, you see there's one side of people who get really scared by some story. And other people are like, hey, it's me. Oh. Oh, nah, 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 nah.
What?
Yeah, I was just going to say that apna guest hai idhar. And we're not listening.
Oh, no.
Hello. Hello. Story.
Unnerving.
Shashank has been trying to get here for a long time. And he's got a scary dream story.
Hey, nice. Suresh is like the MC na, at the party. Yeah. Hello everyone, Shashank. Shashank has got a great story.
Kambola Nights Pay. 44.
Gaadi number 302. You're blocking the entrance.
Ye 4 saal ka bachcha kis ka hai, please.
Acha, bichara, unnerving story.
Bolne do na usko story.
Boli, sir.
Boliye, boliye.
I'll tell you what happened to my friend in Bandra.
Abhi baja aega na, bhido.
Tell us.
Do tell us, Cyrus.
So he started the story.
Again in Bandra.
Bandra.
Ghar ki taraf aage.
Mount Mary, near Mount Mary. Goes out, dresses up and stuff. Has all the lines. Goes cheering, chatting, chilling. He met a girl. It was a Saturday night. Everybody was chilling. Everybody was partying. Met this girl, really beautiful girl. They really got along well. And she said that after the party, you know, that why don't you come over? I live like across the lane. You know, there's a lane opposite that restaurant. So our house was about 4 minutes away from this place, right? And we get there and we make sweet love, right? And then it's that post-coital sort of hangout. He doesn't really know her, right? He met her like a couple of hours ago. He's got his hands behind his back. He's lying on her bed. Her back was towards him. And she says that, do you believe in the dead? Do you believe in spirits? Do you So he's like, yeah, I mean, I don't know, bro. I mean, you know, it depends. Maybe
he was in high spirits, so he said.
He was really happy. He was just chilling, bro. It's like, do you believe in that? I don't know. And I mean, you keep hearing stupid stories and all that. And she's like, they're not stupid. And then she just looked at him like she just turned around. And you know how someone looks at you for a little longer than they should?
Yeah.
She just turned around and looked at him like that. And she said, I see dead people all the time. And suddenly she turns her head back and she moves it down. And this guy suddenly realized that I don't know this girl. I'm locked in her house. And her back is constantly towards me. And she's like,
she's
being really freaky serious. And he's like half naked. And his jeans are on the floor. And he's like, what do you mean you see people? And she's like, I see them all the time. And there's one in the house right now. And she's not fucking facing him, bro. And he says, I felt my heart rate just start like slowly. And he said, what do you mean right now? She said, there's someone in the house right now, right next to you. She's right next to you. And he said, bro, I slid off the bed and into my jeans like this only, like vertical. He said, some family spirit carried me. I slid into it. And he said, I swear, I thought she's going to turn her head and rotate it, right? And she's just going to, they're just going to kill me. And he said, I just said, I think I'll see you tomorrow. And she said, no, you won't. And he said, I got up. And I dashed out of that house, never went there again. But it was a freaky friggin' date that happened to him. So he's completely stopped dating anybody.
Also, the comics section is saying that's a great way to break up with somebody.
Yeah,
we've had slapping ghosts. You guys remember that ghost was slapping people? Then we have a matka breaking ghost.
Yeah,
we got a bike riding ghost.
It's actually a story, and they are not afraid to show their face. I think the guys with false stories, they are not showing their faces.
Sir, ये मैं story बताना चाहूँगा. ये खुद की मेरी और मेरी girlfriend के साथ की एक story है.
Okay.
और ये story साथ ऐसे हुई थी. मेरी girlfriend वो जयपुर में रहती थी, right? तो उस time में उनको एक flat चाहिए था उनके 3 partners के साथ में. तो हम लोग सारे फ्लैट ढूंढ रहे थे, फाइनली एक फ्लैट मिला हमें जयपुर के बिल्कुल आउटस्कर्ट्स में. और वहां से सामान वगैरह शिफ्टिंग करा हम लोगों ने. और उसके बाद वो जो फ्लैट था सर, आप ये मान के चलें कि उसके ऊपर टेरेस था, सेकंड फ्लोर पे हमारा फ्लैट था, उसके ऊपर टेरेस था. और उस टेरेस के ऊपर में एक और टेरेस था, मतलब जैसे होता है टेरेस है, टेरेस के ऊपर में एक, जी, तो वो टेरेस था. हुआ ये कि ऑल ऑफ ए सडन, मतलब हम लोगों ने सारा सामान वगैरह वहां पे शिफ्ट कर लिया. उसके बाद वो घर बिल्कुल न्यूली बिल्ड था, मतलब बिल्कुल नया बना था वो घर, और मुश्किल से 3-4 महीने हुए होंगे उस घर को बने हुए. तो सब कुछ ठीक था वहां पे, अच्छा बड़ा घर था. तो हुआ क्या, अचानक से जो मेरी जो गर्लफ्रेंड है, मैं गया हुआ था वहां पे, जो मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड है वो अपने वो छत जो था, छत के ऊपर जो छत था वो वहां जाके She started smoking, right? और हुआ क्या, जब आधा घंटा से ज्यादा हो गया, जब हम लोगों को ये लगा कि वो अभी तक आई नहीं है, तो मेरी जो मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड की फ्रेंड थी वो छत पे गई. तो उसने देखा कि वो उसको देख के शी स्टार्टेड स्माइलिंग, राइट? तो शी फिगर्ड इट आउट कि कुछ ना कुछ प्रॉब्लम है. तो उसने मुझे कॉल करी, तो मैं ऊपर गया. जब मैं ऊपर गया तो वो एक टेरेस के पास रुक के शी कॉन्टिन्यूसली स्टार्टेड वोमिटिंग. वो वोमिट कर रही है, कर रही है, कर रही है, वो कुछ नहीं बोल रही है, एक वर्ड भी नहीं बोल रही है, वो वोमिट कर रही है. और वो जो स्टेयर्स था वो बिल्कुल लोहे का स्टेयर्स बना हुआ था, तो हम लोग ना उसको नीचे ले जाते थे ना उसको ऊपर ले जा सकते थे. और करीब आधे घंटे से वो वोमिट कर रही थी. हम लोगों ने सारा कुछ कर लिया. हम लोगों को शक कब हुआ, जब उसने वोमिट करते करते एक शब्द बोला कि वो मुझे उल्टी करने बोल रहा है. अचानक से उसने बोला वो मुझे उल्टी करने बोल रहा है.
Then
I figured it was around 12:30, रात के 12:30 पे. और उसने बोला वो मुझे उल्टी करने बोल रहा है. और चारों तरफ अंधेरा और कम से कम 25-30 कुत्ते भौंक रहे, कॉन्टिन्यूसली डॉग्स वर बार्किंग Continuously.
My God.
तो सर हुआ ये कि हम लोगों ने किसी तरीके से उसको सब कुछ दिया जो भी दे सकते थे, देसी नुस्खा होता है हमारे इंडिया में, किसी तरीके से उसको फ्लैट में लेके आए. तो सर जैसे फ्लैट में लेके आए, उसने अपना जो फेस की तरफ बेड पे रखा और वो बेड पे सो गई. दो से पांच सेकंड के बाद वो दोबारा से उठी. और दोबारा से उठ के उसने कहा कोई है, कोई है, कोई है. तो मुझे समझ में आ गया था कि कुछ ना कुछ प्रॉब्लम है. अब उसके बाद हुआ ये कि उसने कहा कि मेरा नाम लिया, उसने कहा कि यहाँ पे एक लड़का है. और द गाय हु वाज देयर ही वाज कंप्लीटली नेकेड.
ओके.
और उसका एक राइट हैंड नहीं है.
ओके.
और उसके राइट हैंड से कॉन्टिन्यूसली ब्लड गिर रहा है.
Oh my God.
She just saw that guy coming from the main door. It was around between 1 to 1:30, रात के 1:30 बज गए थे तब तक. और उसने कहा कि यहाँ पे कोई है, एक लड़का आ रहा है और वो हमें बार बार वो मेरी तरफ आ रहा है और मुझे पकड़ने की कोशिश कर रहा है. तो उस टाइम में वो मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड थी, उसके साथ में 2 फ्रेंड और थी. उन लोगों की तो लाइक उनको समझ भी नहीं आ रहा था कि लाइक क्या करें. तो मैं एक अकेला मेल बंदा था वहां पे. तो फिर हुआ ये, वो जब उसने बोला कि वो बंदा आ रहा है और जा रहा है, सर फिर क्या हुआ, वो बेहोश हो गई करीब 1 से 2 मिनट के लिए. और वो जो बंदा था वो उसके जिस्म में आया और उसने आके लिटरली ऐसे मोबाइल में ना ऐसे ऐसे गेम खेल रहा था, ऐसे ऐसे गेम खेल रहा था और मुझे बिल्कुल स्ट्रेंज तरीके से मुझे देख रहा था, बिल्कुल स्ट्रेंज तरीके से। और उसने उसने मुझे देख के कहा, अब समझ में आया, अब समझ में आया ये ऊपर क्यों उल्टी कर रही थी, बिल्कुल अजीब आवाज में। मैंने कहा कि मैं समझ गया था कि इसके साथ कुछ ना कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुई है। मैंने कहा कि आपका नाम क्या है, मैंने स्टेटस से पूछा, मैंने कहा कि आपका नाम क्या है। उसने अपना नाम बताया, मेरा नाम नवीन कुमार है। उस वो जो घोष था मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड की बॉडी में घुस के उसने बताया कि मेरा नाम नवीन कुमार है। मैंने कहा तुम्हारी क्या एज है, उसने अपनी एज बताई। उसने कहा कि इस घर के ठीक पीछे मेरा और मेरी सिस्टर का एक्सीडेंट हो गया था और ऑन द स्पॉट हम लोग डेथ कर गए थे। उसके एक साल तक जब ये सारी चीजें हो गई, उसके एक साल तक मतलब वो सारी चीजें खत्म हो गई, सारे गोल्स खत्म हो गए, उसके एक साल तक ये जो पढ़ाई करी गई थी मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड पे, इसका इफेक्ट ये हुआ एक साल तक उसको जितने भी स्पिरिट्स हुआ करते थे वो दिखते थे। लाइक मैं उसके साथ ड्राइव कर रहा हूँ, एक पेड़ पे एक कोई बैठा है तो वो बता रही है कि पेड़ पे कोई बैठा है, मुझे देख रहा है। अगर रूम में अंधेरा हो जाता था और कहीं पे कुछ होता था तो शी यूज्ड टू टेल मी कि यहाँ पर कुछ है, यहाँ से चलो। ये उसका साइड इफेक्ट था। पर ये लिटरली मैंने चीजें 1.5 ईयर के आसपास खुद झेली है।
अभी आप ठीक है एंड इज शी ओके?
अभी जो मेरी गर्लफ्रेंड है वो मेरी वाइफ बन चुकी है और वो यहाँ पे।
वाओ, कांग्रेचुलेशंस।
हाय
हाय,
दिस इज ऑल रियल?
This is all real story, sir. And this happened in 2018. It is very recent.
Thank you,
thank
sir.
Thank you, man. Take care.
I hope we never meet you again.
देखिए,
it's very scary.
एक चीज, एक चीज जो मैंने very unnerving, but if it's a true story,
okay. Fucking, if this story is even remotely true, at pause.
Oh my God! You're a lot younger.
Shit. You guys don't understand. Through this whole stream, there has been crazy lightning outside, and now we got mad thunder. Fucking hell! Cyril is close by, so he felt it also. I saw him jump.
Building vibrated this now.
Okay, so you know, I was in 10th class. So I had a friend. So
ये मुंह से सुपारी निकाल के बात कर रहे बाबा।
इसके मुंह में पैदाशी सुपारी है।
Like you know, she skipped school, like for a week. So like next week I met her. I asked her. कि यार कहाँ थे इतने दिन। सो वी वर नॉट वेरी गुड फ्रेंड्स एट दैट पॉइंट, वी वर जस्ट फ्रेंड्स, यू नो, कैजुअल फ्रेंड्स। सो शी टोल्ड मी दैट यार वी वर शिफ्टिंग हर हाउस एंड ऑल, बट यू नो आई आस्क्ड हर कि यार अभी तूने 6 महीने पहले भी हाउस शिफ्ट किया था तो दोबारा क्यों कर रही है। कहती नो बिग डील, यू नो द हाउस डिडंट सूट अस, सो वी आर जस्ट मूविंग आउट अगेन, नो बिग इशू। सो मैंने उसे कुछ ज्यादा पूछा नहीं, आई वाज लाइक ओके जो भी इशू है। देन 2 ईयर्स लेटर वी वर रियली गुड फ्रेंड्स। सो लाइक वी वर हैविंग अ कन्वर्सेशन वन डे, लाइक यू नो, लाइक अबाउट दिस कोर्स एंड ऑल। So she was like, okay, I had a story. So she said, remember I moved out of my house after 6 months. Yeah, I told her, yeah, I remember about that. So she told, she asked me, do you know what really happened? I was like, no, I don't have any idea. So she told me that that house was haunted. And so maine pucha ki yaar aisa kya ho gaya haunted, you know, ki tumhe 6 mahine bhi chhodna pada wo. So she said like ki इंस्टेंसेस हो रहे थे कुछ कि लाइक चीजें हम कहीं रखते थे वो मिलती कहीं पे थी, एंड यू नो ऑल दोस सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग। रात को लाइक बैंग्स होते थे एंड नॉक्स होते थे वॉल्स। मैंने कहा ओके, सो यू नो द थिंग इज शी यूज्ड टू हैव वॉइस ऑफ अ कैट मियाउइंग, एंड द नॉइस ऑफ दैट मियाउइंग केम फ्रॉम द वॉल साइड, यू नो, लाइक लाइक द कैट इज देयर बट इट्स नॉट इन द like balcony, छज्जे पे नहीं है बिल्ली, like कहीं दूर corner में है, so they used to feel like there's a presence of a cat in the house.
Oh my God!
And yeah, one thing I want to like point it out is like she was at that time when this happened, she was like 15 years old, her parents were both working, and her elder brother was out for his higher studies out of Delhi, right? So there were days when she would be alone at house like up till 4-5 PM, right? So she used to call her house, she used to call her friend to her house, you know, to spend some time with. She used to like live in the same society.
Yeah.
So what happened once was they started hearing meowing again. Right. And yeah, she told her
thank you,
about this to her parents, but you know, they never really, you know, लाइक उन्होंने कभी इतना ध्यान नहीं दिया कि यार बच्ची है कुछ होता हो गया जो भी है. सो शी एंड हर फ्रेंड वर हाउस अलोन. इट वाज लाइक 2-3 PM, नॉट दैट लेट. सो दे लाइक स्टार्टेड हियरिंग वॉइसेस लाइक मियाउइंग एंड हर फ्रेंड हर्ड इट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. सो दे स्टार्टेड लाइक लुकिंग अराउंड कि यार कहाँ से आवाज आ रही है. सो एट वन पॉइंट आवाज बाहर से आने लगी, जो उनका लाइक घर का जो डोर था उसके पीछे से आवाज आने लगी उनको. ठीक है. एंड दे गॉट रियली स्केयर्ड कि यार ये अब हम गेट तो खोलेंगे नहीं. तो बेसिकली होता कैसा था उनका हाउस की एक वुडन डोर था और वुडन डोर के पीछे एक मेटल डोर था. यू नो सो द वुडन डोर वॉज क्लोज एंड देर वॉज अ लिटिल गैप अंडर द डोर. सो वॉट दे डिड वॉज दे पीक्ड अंडर द डोर एंड दे सॉ फीट.
दे सॉ माय गॉड व्हाट
राइट. एंड लाइक दे उनकी फट गई. मैम उसने मुझे लिटरली ऐसा बताया कि मेरी फट गई वो फीट देख के.
Where did they where did they see these feet behind the storeroom?
And what kind of feet were they? Human feet like or baby feet? Or
no, the cats? Human feet only. Human feet. But the voice they were heard was of cat. You know, it was like echoing around the house. And at one point, it was coming from behind that door. You know, like for like a few minutes, it was coming from outside the door. And they were like too scared to open the door. So they just, you know, thought let's just peek like below the door. So they got really scared. They saw feet. And you know, if someone is outside your house, like a couple of inches away, they should knock or they should ring the bell. But no, the person was standing, so they kind of noticed it. And uski dost ne phir kya kaha, apni mummy ko bulaya ki mummy, hamari matlab unhone pata nahi kya bola, but mummy, aap aa jao yahan pe, hamare sath kuch ho gaya hai. So then they explained the story.
Fat rahi hai.
So then unhone bulaya ki haan, ye flat number hai, ye building number hai, idhar aa jao aap. So she came in. एंड फिर वो अपनी दोस्त के घर चली गई. उसने अपनी मम्मी को बताया रात को, मम्मी ऐसा हुआ हमारे साथ. ठीक है. सो उसकी मॉम को भी था थोड़ा कि रात कोई आवाज़ें आती थी, नॉइस आती थी. उन्होंने लाइक प्लम्बर को बुलाया था, लाइक उन्होंने नेबर से पूछा था कि आपको ऐसी आवाज़ आती है, बट नो बाकी सब नॉर्मल था. उन्हीं के एक फ्लैट में आवाज़ें आती थी. सो नाउ यू नो वॉट लेट देम टू लीव द हाउस. यू नो नाउ लाइक उसकी मॉम थोड़ा कंसर्न थी कि हाँ हो सकता है कुछ. But what led them to like shift the house was one day on a Sunday, like all her family were out for lunch, right? So like and his father used to own a business near this area. So unka jo hai colleagues ka matlab jo unke employees the unka ghar pe aana jaana laga rehta tha. When he like used to work from home to unka aana jaana laga rehta tha. So because business log karte to unka hote hai ki unka there is no day off in when you have a business, right?
Correct.
So, उनका एक एम्प्लॉय उनके घर पे आया. ठीक है. सो फिर देन ही कॉल्ड हिज माय हर फादर माय फ्रेंड्स फादर कि यार आप ये गेट क्यों नहीं खोल रहे हो, इतनी देर से मैं बेल बजा रहा हूँ, अंदर से आवाजें आ रही है, गेट नहीं खोल रहे हो. सो ही सेड कि घर पे कोई नहीं, हम तो यहाँ पे सब लंच करने आए. ठीक है. वो लाइक एंड हिज एम्प्लॉय वाज लाइक व्हाट द फक आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट, यहाँ से आवाजें आ रही है चार पांच लोगों की बात करने की.
ओह माय गॉड.
So like they said to wahin ruk and he rushed they rushed back like 15-20 minutes it took them. And then he explained ki aisa aisa hai ki when I like just main gate ke bahar aaya, I was about to ring the bell, there was like you know noises coming from inside the house, like people were talking, like 3-4 people were talking, and when I just rang the bell they all went silent, right?
Oh yeah. Shit.
Just when I rang the bell all of them went silent and mujhe laga ye mazak kar rahe ho yaar, kya ho raha hai ki andar se mujhe awaazein aa rahi hain and koi gate nahi khol raha hai. And so then you know they sat down after this incident, the family sat down and talked to each other ki, and you know my friend her name was Shruti, so she told her you know ki ha cat ka incident bhi hua tha, maine aapko bataya tha, but you did not like paid much attention to it. So they like okay no issue, so they moved to a rented apartment and they you know place that house on you know for sale. And yeah, so thode time baad fir wo big gaya tha and you know they relocated.
Wow. So yeah, that was the idea. I thought you were going to say unnerving and you really got us there. You said unreal.
Unreal and freaky, man. But this house, they never did any research on what was happening in this house. Ye to matlab aatmaon ka gang tha.
Aatmaon ka gang. Isme do the creepy parts were the idea of a ghost who's not saying anything but making cat noises. Oh my God, I would be so confused. And the second thing was when they all went silent after that person rang the bell. Wow. Ruthik Thorat and everybody who sent us super chats. I'm sorry if we missed your super chats and didn't read them. In the night, I throw coins on myself and then I read the super chats alone at home. So that really helps. Thank you so much, guys. We'll see you next week. Please do not forget to go to the description, find all these lovely people on the panel and the people who made the thumbnail artwork and made beautiful music stuff. like Ninad's great stuff.
Beautiful, dude.
Really such nice stuff.
Please go send them some love. And if you have not already, don't forget to hit like on this stream. You have witnessed another unnerving episode of Ghost Stories. Y'all can just make weird sounds now. I'll switch to the end. Oh.
Guys, I'm gonna go take a pee.
Okay.
Because apparently last time I fucked up and didn't end the stream and I kept talking.
Oh. And you didn't pee.
So guys, I was trying to end the stream and y'all were not supposed to say anything. So we're gonna try that again now.
Oh.
Connie, look.
This is the post-credit scene, like you have it in good movies, not here. So here we go, guys. You witnessed another episode of Unnerving Ghost Story. Yeah, so we're just going to do that one more time because the music refused to play. You know, this is the bloopers at the end of the movie, you know, where all the actors are having fun. And okay, here we go again, guys. Thank you so much for watching. You witnessed another unnerving episode of Ghost Story.